We are going to go through five different stages of model-based design. First, we model the converter, calculate the most efficient operating region. Then we determine power losses and the thermal behavior of the converter in order to size cooling system appropriately. We are going to design control algorithm based on time frequency domain specification. And we're going to see how we can do this with switch linear system and optimal solver setting. We will design very simple supervisory logic and implement unit testing in order to make sure that everything works as it should. Finally, we are going to implement our design on an embedded platform, such as the one of Texas Instruments that we showcased earlier. But let me give you the last point first now as a demonstration. You see, on the top left corner, there is the hardware. On the right, I clicked on the button Deploy to Hardware. When I click that, I'm using the hardware support package, which provides the driver and all the connectivity I need to automatically package the design I developed in Simulink as an application for Texas Instruments platform. This will automatically be uploaded after generating code. And then, thanks to external mode, I will be able to see how my system behaves. Right now, I'm stimulating my system with random pulses on and off for my light. And you can see on the bottom left corner, I'm regulating the current with 60 milliampere. On the right, I'm trying to keep my voltage of my converter to 18 volt, because I know this is the region where my converter operates most efficiently. What is really nice is, as you can see, the control system is not performing too badly. It's not easy for him to react every time I power on and off my LEDs, but it's actually quite stable, and all the value I used for my PI controller, both for the current and the voltage, are derived from a tuning technique in simulation. I didn't change them once deployed to the hardware, and still they are behaving very well.